the fact it was a disappointment
for the whole nation.
Yes, in the whole nation, yes. But
we did manage to.
But we did manage to.
In few years.
In few months.
Not years.
To regain our spirit, to regain our spirit. The defeat was in June 67. The first raid of the commandos was in Ras Al Aish to prevent the enemy to continue from Ras Al Aish towards Port Fuad. In this action, the Navy participates by the guns of the destroyer, which was at Port Said, and stopped in cooperation with the commandos the enemy to continue from Ras Al Aish to Port Said. After that, the air raid of the aviation against objectives in Sinai Peninsula in July also. Then after that, October, the destruction of the, sunk of the Eilat destroyer. So we didn't take long time to regain our spirit.
Then just right after the defeat, we started to rebuild, and we did a great job there.
What, please?
Just right after the defeat in 1967, we started to rebuild again.
Yes.
And we did a great job there, rebuilding the army and the navy and the air force just in few months and years later on, till we returned
the disaster
back to our
is
position
the disaster
and managed
is
to regain the
yes,
land
yes,
again
yes,
and
yes,
regain
yes,
our
yes.
dignity as well.
You see the appointment of...
But of course we can't deny that a lot of work has been done to achieve these results.
Yes, yes, yes.
And a lot of people stand bravely behind this.
Yes, yes, yes. First, that Nasser, when he said what is taken by force
should
be returned,
by force.
Regained by force. This is the main religion which was reflected on the policies, the diplomacy to prepare for regaining the Sinai Peninsula, and for the economy to be economy of war.
Now we'll talk about a nation in the rebuild operation. How we managed to change dynamics of the game and get out of a complete defeat in 1967, just in few months, as you were saying, to regain the land just in about 6 years, the whole land, and achieve tremendous victory that made the headlines all over the world. Many men stood behind this victory. Tell us a little bit more about efforts that have been put to achieve this victory.
Okay. I will speak in this concert about the Navy, how there are many...
How to jump from the defeat to victory in just few months or years? How was that done? And who really stood behind that?
Who really stood behind that is the people of Egypt, is the people of Egypt. They denied the defeat. And also the armed forces denied the defeat. And they began to make all the efforts towards...
The military and the civilians, they both refused the defeat. So they collaborated together to achieve this victory.
And the leader, Gamal Abdel Nasser, was a good leader. So what he did, Gamal Abdel Nasser, he appointed General Fawzi. He was a very strict and firm. And
in fact, a lot of changes should have been done to overcome this defeat. What was the main thing done at that time to change the defeat to victory?
After the defeat, you know that there was some misunderstanding.
They must change tactics. They must change people at the same time. They must change plans.
You know that the defeat of June 67 was not the fault of the army or the navy. It is a fault, political fault.
It's whose political fault?
Whose fault is because there is no... again, there is no...
homogeneous feeling among
between the political leaders and the army leaders. This is the first one. this is not homogeneous.
They were not on good terms together.
In good terms. Why? Because they close the entrance of Aqaba Bay. Mm. Closing the enemy in the entrance of Aqaba Bay, this means that we declare war on Israel because we stop any trade from Eilat to east of Africa or Asia. Mm. This is the fault. The other fault is that we didn't follow the principles of war, such as the surprise. Surprise. We didn't make a surprise. In October, where there was a good surprise and deceiving. Mm. But in 76, there's no surprise because the army passed through the streets. We are going to fight. So Israel prepared itself and then make the attack.
They were attack a little bit
relaxed. Relaxed. And there is no control of
and
the
they
forces.
They didn't have the re-evaluation of the situation.
Yes,
then.
Yes. And you see also the commander of the armed forces at that time is Abdelhakim Amir. Abdelhakim Amir against Moshe Dayan. There is great difference in experience and in everything. But in October war, you see that all the leaders of the army.
It was another spirit, it was another the whole spirit. Nation.
Yes. So we tried to rebuild our forces, to bring new arms from Soviet Union. They aid us to bring new arms, new ships, new one-motor rocket boats. They send experts to train us. I am one in the reconnaissance department. I have 6 experts from Russia. I have great use of them to plan and organize and execute reconnaissance. Helped me very much. This is
how loyal were they?
Some of them, was not.
We're really wanting to present their expertise to the Egyptians. Most of them were at that condition.
So it is the job of the security department who watch all these experts, watch all these experts. But we have a great benefit, the army.
But in terms of training our troops, they
yes,
did a great
yes,
job.
Yes, yes. We have trained too much with troops, Russian troops, Russian Navy, Russian aviation. We have a great experience. Otherwise, we cannot pass the Suez Canal with the Russian. But here, the in October war, this war is controlled.
Without the Russian expertise.
Yes, expertise. But you know that Sadat repelled them. Yes, before this. So there is a great difference between October war and 67 war. October war is controlled by scientific work, scientific thoughts. The other one, it has no aim, no aim. What is the aim of 67? There was some collections at Syria, and it's false. And then we pass the Suez Canal to cooperate with Syria. This deceive from Russia and from America to put our forces in this critic position and give the opportunity to Israel to destroy our force.
Just before the interview, we talked about some personal challenge that you'd like to share with our viewers and how you did manage to overcome these challenges.
But the personal challenge is the sickness. I passed with some troubles in the heart and the cancer. But I thank God for overcoming this. I obey the orders of the doctors. And I am now, thank God, because I am still now, till now, after the challenging of this disease. Because I think all challenges may be not as you have a challenge to...
I was just about to ask, what was the greater challenge? Was that one of the war or the personal challenge?
This is what I say about the sickness is personal challenge. Mm. But in the war, the personal challenge is that sometimes I have reconnaissance groups which go to the ports of Israel. Mm. So Israel can capture some of them. Mm. How I can challenge this? Mm. This was very difficult because I must make relations with the intelligence service to plan and change my plans and to succeed in other
things. Yeah. Wrapping up this special interview about the Navy, I'd like to present our viewers some keys to success from one of our Navy admirals.
In order to succeed, I want as soon as possible to make a base of
strategic thinking.
Yes, strategic thinking. To make a base of national industry of warships, because we must have our own scientists and materials and money in order to cooperate with Arab people or Arab nations and nations which have the critical technology in order to build up a naval industry for producing destroyers, submarines like this, and not to be in need of other countries.
And I think we as a nation were capable of doing this with collaborating our efforts together.
Now?
Yeah.
It was before this in the with Saudi Arabia and Emirat, but after 67 war, this cooperation. Mm. So we must try to have this cooperation now. To have.
Maybe we both can dream of achieving such cooperation.
Yes.
Among the whole region to build the great bloc.
Yes. At this time, we have.
We are in a dire need to build such a bloc.
Yes. You see that the Navy, without cooperation with Arab countries, mm. so we lose a very strong points mm. in our hand, the using the theater of operation mm. in the Red Sea and the Mediterranean Sea. Mm. All these theaters are covered with the Arab countries, mm. so we must have cooperation. If we have not cooperation with the Arabs in October war, we will not gain the operation mm-hmm. because we started from Port Sudan, Hodeida, Aden to deny the sea communications of Israel. Mm. So without the cooperation of Arab, we can't succeed in the Navy operations.
Mm. Real Admiral Yousry Kandil, all the pleasure speaking to you. Well, that wraps up a very special interview about the Navy. One of our great success stories. Hope you've enjoyed it. Watch us again next time for another story of success.